Hello students, today we are going to study Introduction to Railway Engineering. Now, what do you mean by rails? The rails on the track can be considered as steel girders for the purpose of carrying axle load. Rail transfer axle load to the subgrade through sleepers and ballast. Rail convert the moving wheel loads of train into point load which acts on the sleeper. Rails are made up of high carbon steel to resist wear and tear. On points and crossings, rails of medium carbon and high manganese steel is used. In India, rails are manufactured by open hearth or duplex process. Now, requirement of rails. Vertical stiffeners should be high enough to transmit the vertical load. For that, height of the rail should be adequate. Rails should be capable of withstanding lateral forces. Large width of head and foot will result into larger lateral stiffness. To allow adequate margin of vertical wear, head of the rail must be sufficiently deep. Maximum wear of head allowed is 10 mm. Now the minimum tensile strength of rail should be 72 kg per meter square. In India, rails are tested by falling weight test. Now the types of rail. The first one is double headed rail. These rails were used in the beginning. The idea was when the head will worn out in course of time, the rail can be inverted and reused. In the lower part, the inundations were so formed that smooth running over that surface at the top was impossible. So, idea got failed. Now, this is the double headed rail. Now, next is the bull headed rail. In bull headed rail, the head was made a little thicker and stronger than the lower part. Now, the last one will be the flat footed rail. Flat footed rail are also called Vignoles rails after the name of the inventor. Bearing plates are used between the sleeper and rail at rail joints. These rails are designated by weight of rail per unit length. 52 kg per meter or 52 mr and 62 kg per meter or 60 mr flat footed rails are used in India. 52 kg rail is suitable up to speed of 130 km per hour and 60 kg rail is suitable up to speed of 160 km per hour. Comparison between flat footed rails and bull headed rails. In the first column, point of comparison is written. In second column, flat footed rail is written. And in the third column, bull headed or double headed rail is written. Now the first point is for strength and stiffness. In flat footed rails, they have more strength and stiffness for same weight, whereas bull headed or double headed having lesser stiffness and strength. Now the second point of comparison is laying and relaying. In case of flat footed rail, fitting is simpler, so can be easily laid or relaid. But in case of bull headed, laying or relaying is difficult. Now the next point of comparison is initial cost. In case of flat footed rail, fastenings are lesser and cheaper, so initial cost is less. But in bull headed or double headed rails, fastenings are more and costly, so initial cost is high. Now the next point of comparison is maintenance cost. In case of flat footed rail, less maintenance cost is there. But in case of bull headed or double headed rail, it requires heavy maintenance cost. Now the next topic is the length of the rails. Rails of larger length are preferred to smaller length. Joints are weakest point of the railway track and cost of fastener is also high. In longer rails, number of joints are less, so gives more strength and economy for railway track. Rail length is restricted due to transportation limitations and due to more gap required for expansion joints. Rail length of 12.8 meter nearly equals to 13 meter for broad gauge tracks and rail length of 11.89 meter nearly equals to 12 meter for meter gauge tracks are used by Indian Railways. Now, Important points. Ratio of weight of rail to weight of locomotive, that is axle load, is 1:510. When wear of head exceeds 5% of total weight of the rail, must be replaced. On the curves, check rails parallel to inner rail can be introduced to control wear. Check rail prevent the wear of outer rail. Check rail is used if curves, that is degree of curve, is more than 8 degree for broad gauge and more than 14 degree for meter gauge. Now next is the defect on rails. First one is corrugated rail. The corrugation of rail consists of minute depressions on the surface of the rails. These are usually created at the place where either brakes are applied or train starts. When train passes over it, roaring sound occurs, which is shown here. Next one is the kinks in rail. When ends of adjoining rails move slightly out position, kinks are formed. These occurs due to loose packing of joints, which is shown here. Next is the hogged rail. These are created due to battering impact action of wheel at the end of rail. Head gets bent down, which is shown here like this. These occurs due to loose packing of ballast or loose fish plates at the joints. Gauges in railway track. Gauge of the railway track is defined as the clear distance between inner or running faces of two track rails. The distance between the inner faces of a pair of wheel is called wheel gauge. Now different types of gauges are broad gauge, which will be equals to 1.676 meter, meter gauge, which will be equals to 1 meter, narrow gauge 0.762 meter, and standard gauge, that is 1.435 meter, which is used in UK and USA. Now next topic is the coning of the wheel. The wheels of the train are made at a slope of 1:20. This is known as coning of the wheel, which is shown here. Now the advantages of coning the wheels. Coning the wheels reduces the depreciation of the wheel rims and rails. Depreciation is caused because of the friction action of rims with inner faces of the rail top. Coning also gives an option of lateral drift of the hinge with its wheels. Coning also prevents to some extent the slipping of the wheels. Now next is the creep of rails. It is defined as the longitudinal movement of rails with respect to sleeper in a track, which is shown here. Now causes of creep. Wave motion of trains, expansion and contraction of rails due to variation in temperature, due to starting, accelerating, slowing down and stopping of trains. Another cause is rail deflection under the moving loads from the wheels. Next one is heavy traffic in one direction. Another one is greater on curves. Next one is old rails have more creep. Another one is more with steep gradient. And the last one is poor maintenance of track. Now the next topic is sleepers and ballast. Sleepers are used as a base for laying railway tracks. Sleepers were traditionally made from wood, but are now usually made from concrete. Ties are laid on top of sand, gravel or heavy crushed stone called ballast, which is shown here. That is the railway sleeper and that is the track ballast. Now here also ballast bed is shown here and the sleeper is shown here. This is the rails. Now the next topic is the functions of sleeper. To hold the rails to proper gauge in all situations, that is exact gauge along straight and flat curves, slightly loose on sharp curves and slightly tight in diamond crossings. To support the rails firmly and evenly throughout, the next function is to distribute the load transmitted through rails over large area of ballast underneath or to the bridge girders as the case may be. Now the next function is to hold the rails to proper level in turnouts and crossovers and at 1 in 20 invert slope along straight tracks. Now the next function is to provide an elastic medium between the rails and ballast and also to absorb the vibrations caused due to moving axle loads. Now the next function is to maintain proper alignment of the track on curves. Proper cant is provided by raising the outer rail and tamping the required quantity of ballast below the rails. Next function is to provide the general stability of the permanent way throughout. Another one is to provide the insulation of track for the electrified for signaling. Next one is to provide easy replacement of the rail fastenings without any serious traffic disturbances. Another one is holding rails to correct gauge and alignment. Next one is firm and even support to rails. Next one is transferring the load evenly from rails to wider area of ballast. Another one is elastic medium between rails and ballast. And the last one is providing longitudinal and lateral stability. Now the next topic is the types of sleepers. Sleepers based on the material have different types, that is timber sleepers, steel sleepers, cast iron sleepers, RCC sleepers, pre-stressed concrete sleepers. And sleepers depending on the location, it is of two types, that is longitudinal sleepers and transverse sleepers. The first one is longitudinal sleepers. These are earlier form of sleepers which are not in use nowadays. It consists of slabs or pieces of timber placed parallel to the rails. To maintain the correct gauge, cross pieces were provided. These sleepers were costly. Noise created by the track is considerable. This is the example of longitudinal sleepers. These are the examples of longitudinal sleepers. Next one is the transverse sleepers, also known as cross sleepers, placed at right angle under the rails. Now the next point is eliminated the inconvenience of longitudinal sleeper. Now these are the examples of transverse sleepers. Now the next type of sleeper is timber sleepers or wooden sleepers. Ideal type and universally used, they are two categories of hardwood sleepers such as sal, teak, kongu, etc. and softwood sleepers such as deodar, cheer, treated timbers are used in this category. These are the examples of wooden sleepers. Now the advantages of wooden sleepers. They have proved very useful for heavy loads and high speed trains. They are cheap and easy to manufacture. They can be handled easily without any damage. They maintain the correct alignment. They are most suitable for track circuiting. They can be used with or without ballast. They can be used for gauntlet tracks. They are suitable in the areas having yielding formations. Now the disadvantages of wooden sleepers. They are easily subjected to wear and decay due to various factors, that is vermin, white ants, rail cutting, warping, etc. Hence, these have a short life. Now, what are the disadvantages of wooden sleeper? They do not maintain the gauge accurately. They easily develop cracks with beater packing. They require the highest maintenance cost as compared to other types of sleepers. They get easily disturbed from their position under heavy loads. They need special treatment for fire protection. Their scrap value is low and they are not suitable for modern LWR track because of their lighter weight. Now description of wooden sleepers. Size of wooden sleepers in mm for broad gauge is given as: for ordinary track, it will be equals to 2750 into 250 into 130. And the life of sleeper will be durable for 19 years for broad gauge and 31 years for meter gauge. Now the next type of sleeper is steel sleepers. They are in the form of steel trough on which rails are fixed by keys or nuts or bolts, which is shown here. Now the advantages of steel sleepers. The steel sleepers possess the following advantages. They are manufactured by a simple operation. They can be easily handled as these are light in weight as compared to other types of sleepers. Hence, damages during handling and transporting are less. Less number of fastenings are required and that too simple in nature. The maintenance and adjustment of gauge are easy as compared to the other types of sleepers. These sleepers are rolled section in one piece. Their life is longer than that of other types of sleepers. They provide better lateral rigidity to the track. They are not attacked by vermin. They are not susceptible to fire hazards. Their scrap value is good. Now the disadvantages of steel sleepers. The steel sleepers possess the following disadvantages. First one is they get easily rusted and corroded. They develop cracks at rail seats or near lugs. Their lugs gets broken easily. The steel sleepers do not provide effective track circuiting. The steel sleepers can only be for the type of rails for which these are manufactured. These develop the tendency to become center bound because of slope at both ends. The overall cost of steel sleepers is more than that of timber sleepers. Now the next type of sleeper is cast iron sleepers. Sleepers made of cast iron are called cast iron sleepers. Now the types of cast iron sleepers are, first one is CI pot sleepers and next one is CST9 sleepers, which is shown here. Now the advantages of cast iron sleepers. Longer life, up to 50 to 60 years. High scrap value as they can be remolded. Can be manufactured locally. Provide sufficient bearing area, much stronger at the rail seat, prevent and check creep of rail, they are not attacked by vermin. Now the disadvantages of cast iron sleepers, they are prone to corrosion and cannot be used in salty formation and coastal areas. Not suitable for track circuited portions of railway, can badly damage under derailment. Difficult to maintain the gauge as the two pots are independent. Requires a large number of fastening materials. Difficult to handle and may be easily damaged. Lack of good shock absorber. They are expensive. Now the next type of sleeper is concrete sleepers. RCC and pre-stressed concrete sleepers are now replacing all other types of sleepers except to some special circumstances such as crossing bridges, etc. Here timber sleepers are used. They were first of all used in France roundabout in 1914 but are common since 1950. They may be a twin block sleepers joined by an angle iron. It may be a single block pre-stressed type. Concrete sleepers are much heavier than wooden ones so they resist movement better, which is shown here. Now the advantages of concrete sleeper. Durable with life range from 40 to 50 years. They can be produced on large quantity locally by installing a plant. Heavier than all other types, thus giving better lateral stability to the track. Good insulators and thus suitable for use in track circuited lines. Efficient in controlling creep. They are not attacked by corrosion. Free from attacks of vermin and decay, suitable for all types of soils, more suitable for welded tracks, prevent buckling more efficiently, initial cost is high but proves to be economical in long run, effectively and strongly hold the track to gauge, inflammable and fire resistant. Now the disadvantages of concrete sleepers. Difficult to be handled, difficult to be manufactured in different sizes, thus cannot be used in bridges and crossings. Can be damaged easily while loading and unloading. Now the next type of sleeper is pre-stressed concrete sleepers. The concrete is put under a very high initial compression. All the disadvantages of reinforced concrete sleepers have been eliminated by pre-stressing sleepers. Two types of pre-stressed sleepers are present. The first one is pre-tensioned sleeper and the next one is post-tensioned sleeper, which is shown here. That is all about the introduction to railway engineering. Thank you very much, students.